There's a tremendous amount of interest here in Foxdale in the establishment of this therapy pool. I've seen firsthand how a pool added to a retirement community can really establish a wellness culture that for both staff and residents. Mobility issues, residents with Parkinson's, arthritis, it really gives them a way to do exercises in an area where the buoyancy of the water is taking the weight off them. They can really benefit from that in the exercises that they're doing. We also envision the pool as being a great benefit to our staff members and see it as kind of an integral part of our ongoing wellness program for staff. Our hope is that the pool would also be used by some of our local nonprofits. We've particularly already started some conversations with the local senior centers, but we really want to look at the pool as benefiting our staff, our residents, but also the local community in general. And we are certainly approaching it that way. And the residents have a lot of interest in that, and that comes up often in our conversations here. The board has approved for the project to move forward contingent on a successful fundraising campaign of at least $600,000. And we believe we can raise more than that. And there is a matching component that you'll be hearing more about later in this video. Foxdale's coming up on its 25th anniversary to be celebrated next fall. And it's our hope that we can have this project completed by then. And we are moving into the capital campaign phase. And we're asking everyone to join those of us in this video who have already made our financial commitment to this campaign. And together, we can bring the healing waters that we would like to see here to the Foxdale campus.
My wife has always been a rather active person, and one of her regular activities was walking with friends, often several times a week. And during one of those walks, she fell, and somehow, no one quite understands how, but she hit her head sufficiently firmly that it led to a brain hemorrhage. And that was operated on and all, but it has left her without practical use of her right arm and leg and with very little speech. So having a pool at Foxdale would be an enormous boon. There are all sorts of exercises that she would be able to do in a weightless environment that she cannot otherwise do.
Hi, I'm Myra Sletson, and I'm a member of the Foxdale Board of Trustees, and most people know me in that capacity. But you should also know that my parents, Toby and Jack Sletson, were residents of Foxdale from the mid-90s to the mid-2000s. And my mother and father loved swimming, and they loved the ocean, and we were brought up in water, we were brought up in pools. My mother was very ill. She couldn't walk very easily, and she was also very heavy. Water therapy was wonderful for her, and it enabled her to do the exercises that she needed to do without fear of falling, without fear of hurting someone. And my parents went to extraordinary lengths to try to get water therapy for my mother in kind of inappropriate settings. It became very difficult. My mother ultimately gave up really any sort of movement therapy because she was constantly worried about falling and hurting someone and hurting herself. And I really believe that had there been a therapy pool here at Foxdale, both my parents would have enjoyed a higher quality of health and they would have lived longer because I think my mother would have taken advantage of it. So I really, really believe in this cause and I urge you all to give what you can. I think it will greatly improve the quality of life here and fill a need for so many people that we really can't address right now with the current state of the facilities.
There's so many things we can do in the water that are safer to do in the water and more enjoyable. And we work on functional fitness, and if you think about the first three letters of functional, it's fun. And if people don't have fun, they don't come back. if you can get people to move, mobility is what our life on land is all about. We are training people in the water for life on land. So we need to walk in every direction, move in every direction. We can do a lot of work for our shoulders by getting them under the water and helping.
Take a person who has advanced arthritis. It's very difficult to exercise on land. I can get them into water where buoyancy now aids us in range of motion with our limbs. And we've taken that body weight off and had the joint more supported. We get a bigger range of motion and more ability to move than what we have in land. So it aids us with people with advanced arthritis, people who've had strokes, just a lot of different diseases are aided by working out in water as opposed to on land.
Well, Foxdale certainly has the health and wellness of all its residents as a top priority. And this is the one piece that we've been missing. I've been in a variety of aquatic settings throughout my life, both as a participant and as a teacher. The water becomes an equalizer. Folks who can't do particular movements on land can all at once do them in the water. It's just absolutely wonderful to see their smiles when they find out that movement can be fun again. There's just no question that a therapy pool can enhance the quality of life of Foxdale residents. And not only that, I think it will lift our spirits. A pool that's purposefully designed as a therapy pool has a lot of advantages. The design of the pool will facilitate getting those who are physically challenged, perhaps even wheelchair bound, into and out of the pool easily with the use of a ramp. There will be particular areas in the pool that will have jets of water coming out. It almost functions like a hot tub in that regard, with the temperature of the water being warm. The depth of the pool will vary, but only slightly, so that all of our residents should be able to traverse the length of the pool without being worried about slipping into deep water. And of course, we'll have equipment that will be designed specifically for exercise in the water. There will be enough room in the pool to both have exercise classes, which will just be ideal for some, as well as many different kinds of stations for one-on-one assistance. And the best thing about it, I think, is that you don't have to be a swimmer to be able to enjoy the benefits of a therapy pool.
Twenty-five years ago, the founders of Foxdale exhibited extraordinary vision in planning four huge non-income producing spaces in the new community building. And the residents who were here quickly began filling the auditorium, the meeting room, the library, and the art room with extensive programming. And soon Foxdale gained the reputation of being filled with active and vibrant people. And that perception has existed down to today because those kinds of people continue to flock to Foxdale. Now in 2040, Foxdale will celebrate its 50th anniversary, and it will look back and say that there was extraordinary vision in today's residents for planning this therapy pool. Just as the original founders planned, built, and paid for the community building, we will plan, build, and pay for a first-rate therapy pool. Now there is a capital campaign committee that is charged with raising the money for the project. Every member of that committee has made a financial commitment. You will soon be asked to make a commitment also and join the campaign. The corporate board from a fund given to the board will match dollar for dollar up to $600,000 every dollar that comes in. We ask you, please think way out of the box, stretch as far as you can to make as big a pledge as you can over 3 years. Thank you very much.